in year 2000, boxing sensation Dmitry Salida made it to the finals of the U.S. Nationals of 19 and under. But he was supposed to fight on Saturday at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, something that contradicts with his religion. But Dylan Hernandez, a reporter, wrote USA Boxing, contacted them. They were going to cancel the fight and Dmitry was going to lose. But because of what Dylan did, Dmitry was able to fight and win. I caught up with both of them to talk about that day. Check it out.
Dmitry was still an amateur, and I was an intern at the Biloxi Sun-Herald in Biloxi, Mississippi, coast town, casino town. And, Dmitry was there fighting at the U.S. Amateur National Championships, and I covered him. And, you know, there were some, like, issues that came up over the course of that, and, you know, Dmitry won that tournament, and I followed him from afar, just as I did a lot of the other fighters that came out of that tournament.
Like, who else was there that year?
Ray Sanchez was there, a kid named David Rodella.
Good friend of mine, I just talked to him.
Oh, really?
Yeah, okay, yeah. From Oxnard.
Yeah.
David, he was the Mexican national team. Do you remember Salida in that tournament at
yeah,
all?
Yeah, I do remember.
How did he do in the tournament?
He was good. He was very quick.
Very strong.
I was strong. I still like him. He's changed his style a little bit for the pros, but, I mean, he's still
doing his thing. He's now, his record's very impressive.
He's doing
like
great, man.
32-1.
And Dylan was working for the Sun-Herald, and it was the first time when I fought in the U.S. Championships that I decided not to fight on the Sabbath. And USA Boxing told me that I would be disqualified. And Dylan Hernandez, I won my semifinal fight. It was an upset victory. And Dylan Hernandez spoke with USA Boxing, and because of his pressure, the fight was changed for me.
In the quarterfinals or semifinals, I fought this kid from Cincinnati, who I thought was, like, by far physically the most gifted fighter there. You know, it was almost like a Roy Jones type of guy where, you know, he didn't have to be in the pocket. You know, he could be, like, 3 feet away from me lunging, and, you know, and he's going to go against Dmitry, and I'm thinking, this kid's going to get smoked, right? But he made the adjustments, and he won the fight. And that's when you kind of start getting a feeling that, okay, he has a pretty good chance to have a successful career.
You don't fight on Friday night until Saturday night sundown. And a guy that helped you achieve that in your career is right here. And he didn't even know what he was doing. He was just doing a story. I do stories I get hated at. He does stories, he helps people's lives.
Yes, it's funny. The interesting part about it is that sometimes you do good things and you don't know the effect that it causes on people. So
I talked to Emmanuel Stewart about him. He told me great things. He goes, Dmitry surprised me. He's actually good. He told me, you saw the video, right? Yes. What do you think about that? Getting confidence from Emmanuel Stewart?
Well, I spent quite a long time at the Crown Gym in Detroit.
Did you whoop all their butts over there?
I did good.
Who are you training with? I saw a picture with a lot of big names.
It's a good gym, yeah. It has a lot of really good boxers, good prospects, good old champions.
Saddam Ali is an observant Muslim. Mm-hmm. Doesn't train during Ramadan because he's fasting during the day, but at night, he trains. Mm-hmm. Dmitry Salida is an observant Jew. Can't train during the Jewish holiday, but at the end of the holiday Sunday. They both found themselves in the same gym after sundown training because of their religion.
That's funny.
It is funny, but it just shows that boxing brings people together like nothing else.
Yeah.
Dmitry told me that when he fought in that tournament, USA Boxing told him, if you don't fight on the Sabbath, if you don't fight on Saturday, we're going to strip you and you're going to lose automatically. Because of your story, they let him fight. Tell me about that. How did that happen?
So that was basically the situation. And, I just did what any reporter would do, which is just ask questions. Hey, what's going on?
And nobody got mad at you, huh?
I can't remember that. Yeah, I actually think that the people were fairly accommodating.
So there you have it. Dylan Hernandez using the power of the media for good. Not like some people. In Beverly Hills, I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.